Hey, what's up, everybody? Prestige here. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Today, we're going to talk a little bit about how I personally rank up fast in Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. I also want to give you guys some tips and pointers on what you guys should do in order to rank up fast as well. We're going to be focusing on domination in this particular gameplay. I'll also be covering other game modes like TDM for those of you that just play Team Deathmatch. I'll also be talking about hardcore game modes like Hardcore Domination and Hardcore Kill Confirmed because I played a lot of that as well while working on my weapons and ranking up at the same time. The gameplay you're watching on the screen right now is also the craziest one I've ever had. It was also the most fun I've ever had while playing Advanced Warfare. Using the SAC-3, this is the dual-wield submachine gun, also known as the double vectors for me, and it's just a very intense gameplay. I drop a 50 bomb, and the ending is surprising. It even surprised me. I hope you guys enjoyed the information in this video, and I hope it helps you rank up as well in Advanced Warfare. So without further ado, let's get right into the information. The first thing that I would like to say is, if you guys are focused on your kill-death ratio and your win-loss ratio, this is not going to be the type of video for you, because honestly, in Advanced Warfare, it's unlike any previous Call of Duty game we've had before it. You can't just go look at anyone's kill-death ratio. You can't go to your buddy and say, I'm going to look at your combat record. You just can't do that in this game. You cannot see anyone else's kill-death ratio, and I think that that is a great thing, and I'm very happy that Sledgehammer Games has done that, because it almost seems like everyone wants to have the biggest E-penis when it comes to kill-death ratio, but none of that even matters. If you want to grind out XP, if you want to grind out rank, listen to this video and take these steps that I tell you. Rule number one to ranking up in any Call of Duty game, you want to make sure that you have one weapon of each category that you're comfortable in with using. I always say at least have one submachine gun and one assault rifle and you'll be good to go. If you want to have a sniper, by all means, go ahead and try that out. But I always say one submachine gun, one assault rifle, and you'll be good to go. And what I mean by this is use a weapon that you can feel like it's almost an extension of yourself, a weapon that you know which attachments are perfect for which situations, which weapons are going to be perfect for certain game modes. For example's sake, my favorite weapon to use in a domination would be a submachine gun. The reason being is because submachine guns let you run and move a lot faster, so I want to get to my objectives faster. And that's just how I play domination. If I was playing Team Deathmatch or Kill Confirmed, I would probably use the HBRA-3 assault rifle or the Atlas 20mm sniper rifle. That's just my favorite sniper. So there are a bunch of situations that you'll have to be ready for, so make sure you have a variety of weapons that you are comfortable with using. Step number two to ranking up fast in Call of Duty, this also applies for any Call of Duty game, make sure you find a game mode that awards the most XP. For everyone that is playing Advanced Warfare that wants to rank up the quickest that they can, Search and Destroy is a good game mode. Search and Destroy gives you a lot of points. All headshots are double experience points. If you have quad XP, that's 8 times the experience points. You're going to be getting a lot of XP with headshots, with kills, with bomb plants, with explosions. Everything, you're going to be getting a lot of experience points, so that is a good thing to use. But for those of you that do not want to play Search and Destroy, that do not like those one death, you're sitting it out the rest of the round game modes, if you don't like respawn game modes, and you want to play like a game where you can constantly spawn in and keep getting kills, Domination is the game mode that I played a lot of that helped me rank up as well. Now, this domination in Advanced Warfare is unlike any other domination we've ever had before. People are able to hover up above the flags to capture them. They don't have to be on the ground. You have to be closer to the flags than we've ever had before. It's just a lot more difficult, but that's part of the fun. Having more fun playing, not worrying about your kill-death ratio, running in, constantly capturing objectives, getting kills while you can. If you die, don't worry about it. That's the mindset that you have to have. You cannot care about your kill-death ratio while playing that type of game mode. You'll see that in this particular gameplay, I die a whole lot because I just don't care. I just want to run in and capture the objective. And that's one thing that I can suggest to anybody out there that wants to rank up. If you're on the flag and you're getting on the flag kills, you get bonus XP. If you are on the flag and you capture it, you get bonus XP. Every kill gives you XP. So do not worry about it one bit when trying and ranking up throughout the game. Just dying. Just going in and capturing as many objectives as you can, getting as many kills as you can while capturing those objectives. That's how you rank up, and that's how I ranked up. So that is my step number two to finding a game mode that works for you. Now, if you're playing Team Deathmatch, if you're playing Kill Confirmed, Just find a weapon that works for you. Team deathmatch is a little hard because it all depends on how many kills that you get. So let's say you're not the best player, but you can still get 20 to 25 kills in a team deathmatch. You're still going to get a pretty decent chunk of XP. I don't mean to switch subjects on you guys, but I want to talk about something that changed as well in Advanced Warfare with all of this earning of XP. A lot of people also rely on the match bonus, and match bonus was changed pretty significantly in Advanced Warfare. So let me explain to you guys what it was before in previous games. So in previous Call of Duty games, every time you complete a match, you would get a match bonus, you know, and that all depends if you stay in the game, if you do well. It was all just randomly generated, randomly calculated, depending on your level as well. So let's say you were level 5, your match bonus may be like 400 or something, 400 extra XP. But if you were like level 55, you might get 2,000 extra XP or 3,000 or 4,000 extra XP just because it takes more for you to rank up. So it would just be randomly generated. Now in Advanced Warfare, if you lose, your match bonus is 1,000 XP. If you win, your match bonus is 2,000 XP. So regardless if you win or lose, you're still going to get some extra XP at the end of the game. And that's something to think about. So that changed, and that helps a lot of people, especially when you start at level 1. If you're level 1 and you get a victory, you get 2,000 XP right at the end of the round. That's going to help you rank up right off the bat. That's a good chunk of XP for anyone in their lower levels. So focusing on a win is more important than focusing on a kill-death ratio in certain circumstances. For those of you that play hardcore game modes, you're going to have to take a few things into consideration while playing the game itself. If you want to rank up fast playing domination, make sure you're constantly capturing flags, but make sure you have certain perks on that can help you. Cold-blooded to keep your name off of the radar, off of a lot of things for enemies. Make sure you're using flak jacket as well. A lot of people like to use noob tubes in hardcore, which is ridiculously stupid. Which is unfortunate as well because it just ruins the game mode for a lot of people. And make sure that you are using low profile as well so you can sneak around them as much as you can. Now, if you are in core, there's a whole bunch of different situations that you have to go with. Now, if the enemy's using danger close, then you might want to use flak jacket, but in other situations, you don't really have to use flak jacket. Frag grenades are pretty powerful, but they're not going to kill you if they're within a certain range. So make sure that you are prepared for all types of situations. You have a class set up and ready. I always like to rock two different classes for all the different game modes that we're playing. We have 10 classes to use if you didn't know. So you can make two domination classes, two TDM classes, which TDM, you really don't need two classes unless you're going to have a sniper class and an assault rifle class. You can also have two classes for hardcore kill confirmed. Hardcore kill confirmed, by the way, is awesome as well. All you have to do is focus on capturing tags. Always make sure to pick up your own tags if you're within vicinity, and if you see enemies that kill other teammates, make sure you pick up your teammates' tags as well. You're going to be earning XP as long as you're constantly capturing all of those tags that are all scattered around the map. And another cool thing that they did with that specific game mode is if you are playing with a team, if you are playing core kill confirmed, you can see every single tag on the radar. Even if your teammate kills the enemy, you'll see exactly where the tag is on the radar. You don't have to kill them now to see where the tag is. And I really like that because it helps find other people's tags. And before, which it was really hard to do because they were just kind of scattered and you would just bump into them. So it makes it a little bit easier for those of you that want to play the objective really hard and find other people's tags. Now, other people might get annoyed when you pick up their tags, but they still get a pretty good chunk of XP as well. So don't worry about it as much as you would like to. So once again, that's something that I cannot stress enough within this video. Make sure you guys are not camping. Score per minute is a important thing. So if you're playing kill confirmed, if you're playing domination, capture as many flags as you can. Capture as many tags as you can. Try to play the objective as much as you can. Support the team. Use UAVs. Use, anything that you can earn and generate extra score from. Use care packages if you have to. You can get share packages. You can make trap packages. People can blow up by those trap packages. Put them on an objective. Make sure you have the thrusters on there so you can follow you right to the B objective or right to the C objective. If you play Search and Destroy, go for the headshots. Go for the kills. Don't be afraid to get killed. Make sure that you're constantly moving, constantly capturing objectives, and constantly becoming a bigger badass than you could ever imagine in Advanced Warfare. This game is there for mobility, and I cannot stress that enough to you guys. You have to make sure you're moving around, capturing as many flags as you can, and just becoming a badass. And that's all I can say. That is my techniques. That's how I got Prestige Master. That's all I can say. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it helped you out. And I hope you enjoyed the ending here, which is a very strange thing. This has never happened to me before in a domination game. But I gotta say, it was neck and neck the entire time. I really hope you guys enjoyed the techniques and enjoyed the video. If you did, please leave a like down below. Do not forget to hit that subscribe button for more awesome videos each and every day. And until next time, I am out. Peace.